Greetings, fellow Oaklings. Welcome back to some Oral Scrolls Arena. Today's task at hand would be to go over to Morrowind and locate Dagoth Ur. So without further ado, let's go. And in other news today, I'm also trying out... I think it should be something near here. But yeah, given the trend of this game, we will probably have to make a quid pro quo deal with somebody. Probably, you know, the major skill of the king or queen or one of the, what do you call it? One of the people of the, you know, some of the other brotherhood, you know, religious order, before we can actually find what we're looking for. So I think we'll start off with Tyr here, and... or do we instead... Hey, let's go to Mournhold. Let us go to Mournhold instead. So, in other news, I am trying out Twitch Studio Beta for the first time today in order to stream my game, and as you Twitch streamers can probably see, I've got my webcam turned on. This is how I normally look like, and the backdrop is a mess because I don't exactly have what you would call a... What would you call it? A green screen. Anyway, moving on. You have arrived in the city-state of Mournhold in Morrowind province. The date is Thedust. 8th of Sun's Dusk in the year 3rd Era 390. It took 25 days to reach your goal. You enter Mournhold, lost city-state of the First Empire. It is said that a great evil resides under the city, slowly driving its citizens mad. Should I be here? Oh, it's night. And it's foggy. Oh, hey, you're there. Dunma, yeah. You guys look a lot like Argonians for some reason. Yeah, where is Dagoth Ur? Someone at the palace said that they found something in Ebonheart. You might try there. Ebonheart it is then. And I practically had to rest in an inn for the night just because... Yeah, right here. Just because it was night during the time of my arrival. So, yeah. Just one of the things about this game, which I don't really approve of, per se, but yeah. The date is Thedas, 15th of Sun's Dusk in the year 390, which we already know. Okay, you're to Ebonheart, also known as the Black City. To the north, you can see the red-orange glow of Dagoth Ur, the fire cone on the Black Isle. This city's ruler has a reputation of being extremely ruthless. What is it with these... Dunma? Yeah, where is Dagoth Ur? Many have journeyed to the mountain in search of great treasure, but few have been heard of again. Those who survived its fiery slopes spoke of demons. If you are bent on traveling this journey, check at the palace. They usually keep records of these things. Huh, at the palace. Oh yeah, where is the palace then? South of here. Why does my compass keep disappearing? So I guess the king or queen or whatever it is wants me to go raid a dungeon in exchange for the location of... let me just mark this place real quick because I'll be returning here. Yeah. In exchange for the location of Dagoth Ur, and then I can get to raid Dagoth Ur. As you enter the audience chamber of the king of Ebonheart, you feel the autumn chill out from the outside is actually intensified within. The thick furs and darkly beautiful ornaments that decorate the walls make you feel as if you're being watched. King Casik looks up from the conference he's having with the Council of Elders. Oh, sorry about that, I didn't mean to disturb you. Wow, this place is actually pretty well decorated. The main hall. And this guy looks pretty different as well. I wonder why. My name is King Casik, and I've heard that you seek Dagoth Ur, the legendary home of the dwarven people. Perhaps we can help one another. Well, I mean, you guys sort of did kill the dwarves. Anyway, I have in my possession the anvil of Mithas, greatest of the dwarven blacksmiths. Only one object was strong enough not to shatter when used to shape metal upon the anvil, the Hammer of Gharik. Gharik? Okay. It is said that the ring of the hammer upon the anvil speaks to the user, telling him the entrance to the Mount of Dagoth Ur. Seriously. I mean, did they like get bored with tablets and the rest of the lot? Anyway, with the raw metals present within the mountain, my blacksmiths will be able to fashion the finest weapons and armor in the realm. Recover the hammer for me. It was supposedly lost in the dungeon known as the Black Gate. I will show you where this dungeon can be found. You will be rewarded for this deed with the location of the entrance to Dagoth Ur. You can then journey there and explore it to your heart's content. Do you agree? Sure. And I guess asking for an army to be sent with me is too much to ask for. You do me a great service, Grimfangs. One that neither I nor my people will easily forget. Come, here is the location of Black Gate. King Casik inscribes the location of the Black Gate. Home of the Hammer of... Oh, Karen. 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 Onto your map. Cool. So, if you decide to break into the armory at night, in the palace, you can actually get like a whole load of gold there. Anyway, but let's go ahead and raid Black Gate. Where is Black Gate? It's quite far, to be honest. I think they should, you know, place the quest in Morrowind. Anyway, moving on. No ambush on the entry. Okay, that's a good sign. Not always, but yeah. I shall just save the game here, because I don't want to journey and read all that again. Skeevers! Awesome. I mean, I saw these guys in the first dungeon, but why do you even bother checking them? I saw these guys in the first dungeon and yeah, they were a real handful, but now not so much. Okay, so let's just get a survey, a lay of the area if you will. There's a path to the left, there's a path to the right, and there's a path to the south. I guess we'll start with the path on the left, I guess. Oh shit! We've got iron golems here. Not iron golems, stone golems. Excuse me. Resist shock. Okay, one more. Heal true. I did not mean to do that. Nothing usable. Let me guess. Nothing usable. Sometimes they can carry some things. They might. They just might. And in those instances, it's always, you know... When they do carry something, they carry a lot. So, yeah. I guess I need to learn to think before I speak as well. These two rooms are interconnected. That is good to know. I guess I'll take a look see around here as well. I see you. I see you sneaking around the corner. Hey, does this game have half-cover mechanics like they do in D&D as well? Because those ranged attacks were supposed to hit me, but they didn't. Quite curious. So this entire place looks like it is interconnected. More skeevers, yay! I always love killing them. Primarily because they gave me a very hard time in the first dungeon, where, you know, you do not have... Ooh, some loot. 86 gold pieces and a round shield. Do I want the round shield? Not really, no. Yeah, so... They usually give you a very difficult time in the very first dungeon. Simply because, well... They are... difficult enemies, if you will. Not difficult enemies, you just aren't... Okay, these guys. These guys can kill you. These guys can actually insta-kill you, so it's... best if you stay wary of them. I'm just going to save here, because I survived that assault. Anyway, yeah, in the first dungeon you aren't armored at all, so it's quite easy for you to be ambushed by these guys. And I see a river here. I wonder where this leads. Hey, how big is this dungeon? So I came up near the northeast entrance, just like Mirkwood. And yeah, it seems to be large, but the pathways aren't too twisted and winding, so I guess we can still manage this without pulling our hair out. Yeah, I see a ghost, I know. Ghosts are good. Ghosts are chill. It's the raids that you need to watch out for. Well, basically it seems to be the only way, so I guess we'll check this out first. Or should I check this area out first? You know what? Let's just wing it. You don't really have an objective marker in this game, and well, it is sort of a dungeon crawler. I mean, it is a dungeon crawler, so deciding where to go next is a major part of the game, because you can sometimes luck out. As in, if you've seen my previous video, if you've seen my previous stream, you would know that I basically lucked out with the location of the way to the next floor when I was raiding Mirkwood. But in this instance, I'm not going to say in this instance because it's too soon to make a conclusion just yet. I've just started raiding this dungeon. Let me just go ahead and save again, just for the sake of it. Probably used the wrong save slot there, but 7 gold pieces and a saber. Let me check out the saber first. Yeah, if you've seen my playthrough of I'm gonna drop it, it's not enchanted, not worth carrying around, not worth losing an inventory slot over. Anyway, if you've seen my playthrough of what was it again? The Crypt of Hearts, yeah. If you have seen my playthrough of the Crypt of Hearts, you'll notice that, yeah, I practically found the way after exploring the rest of the map first. So, yeah, it can be pretty rough if you don't know where to go and what to do. Okay, there was a ghost right there. Sometimes I feel like my armor rating is so damn high that I can't even, you know, feel half of the attacks. But it doesn't really seem to be that high now, does it? Anyway. Yeah, no, these wing buggers are something that you need to be careful about. As you can see, they do a lot of damage. Two wraiths, two of them? Seriously? Well, I guess I was in the nick of time there. And I think it would not be a bad idea to pop in, excuse me, yeah, see, pop in a potion of resist fire, because there was another one here. Okay, it's just a ghost. Nothing to worry about, just a ghost. Quite large and expansive, not unlike the rest of the dungeons we have visited. You know what would really suck? If the entrance was somewhere around here. And honestly, I am tempted to go back and check. It would just spare me a whole load of time, but you know what? Fuck it. We're gonna do what we're gonna do, and if in the end it doesn't pan out for us, we're just gonna go over and check. So yeah, I mean, this dungeon hasn't been awfully, or rather excruciatingly painful yet, but if it does get excruciatingly painful, then yeah, I'll go ahead and check what I need to check. Trolls, these guys regenerate, they'll stab you from behind if you're not careful enough. See? No, this was a different one. I probably should use a potion of healing. And yeah, you basically need to carry a whole ton of potions with you. Because if you don't, you'll run out of potions and you will die in the middle of the dungeon. And are we where I think we are? We seem to be where I think we are. No, we are at another crossroads. But we are also near the west side, and this dungeon doesn't seem as broad and looping as the Crypt of Hearts, or the Mines of Khuras for that matter. So I suppose it wouldn't really hurt to take a gander over on this side. I'll just go ahead and update this save again, because it seems like a safe spot to do so. And we shall continue onwards on our journey. Close one. Yeah, I was about to say that when fighting these guys, it's always advisable to keep a hand on the U button, because these guys can literally consume your health at incredibly fast rates, as you probably saw right now. And I'm just gonna go ahead and pop in a potion of resist shock as well. And I'm gonna save the game here. A wraith. The most annoying thing about these guys is that... What the actual fuck, man? Come on. Yeah, the most annoying thing about these guys is that they just disappear off into nothingness. And they don't even give you anything. For all your troubles. So, yeah. Excuse me. The temperature here has been wildly fluctuating, and yeah, as you can see, it has been taking a toll on my health. Ooh, an iron golem. I always like fighting these guys. Two of them, is it? See, lining a melee attackers like this always helps, because, well, you can take them one at a time, but with ranged attackers, nope. The one in the back is gonna clobber you before the one in the front ever gets a chance to do anything to you. Nothing usable. Something that I wanna do is keep clearing this side of the map. And I guess I will save again. Oh my god, a lava room, no! My experiences with lava rooms have always been quite bad. Primarily because fire spells are just so damaging in this game. And yeah, if there's a lava room, there's gonna be some or the other kind of fucker that's gonna throw a fire spell at you. And yeah, disappear just like this into nowhere, leaving you nothing for defeating them, and at the same time they are, well, just difficult to deal with in general. So this was a lava room. I guess I'll just check over on this corner as well. Shouldn't be anything here, but looks like there is. How far away are we? We can't go any further to the west. I guess I'll just clear this side anyway. I'll just update the save again. This is a broad place. Whoa. Jump scares. Yeah, thank you. Thank you. Thank you for dying. Thank you very much for dying when you did. Okay, so I guess this is the end here? I guess. There doesn't really seem to be much here, but oh well. Do I want to save? Yes, I think I should save first. Just as I saved, I can hear flapping wings. That's never a good sign. Let me try pilfering this. Yeah. A mark. Thy katana. Is it enchanted? Nope. Time to drop it. So the good thing about exploration is it gives you loot, which you can sell to get money. The bad thing about it is, it can easily turn into something that is very frustrating to deal with. Okay, I should be at the end. Quite long. This dungeon is longer than it is broader, so... Oh no, I take that back. Where did I save again? I think I'll just save here. And this place looks like it might hold the key to our salvation, but I don't really see any way to get back inside here yet. But then again, the same thing is, I can see the same thing here as well, so you never really know where things are in this game, unless you, you know, actually go ahead and check them out, so... But the good thing, which I will say, the good thing about this game is that it... I know you're following me. You are following me, I know that. The good thing about this game is once you, at least, like, once you clear a level, clear the enemies in one level, just one level, they don't respawn again. So, yeah, I would say they did a good job with that. Seriously, you're standing in front of me? Or rather, you were standing on top of me. Ring of healing, and I shall just save the game again. So there was nothing here, and I still am glad that I checked though, because if there was, that I probably wouldn't have been able to forget myself. And there does seem to be a V down at the very corner here, which I'm guessing is just a glitch. But yeah, failed to build for this? Thought not. Another queue to save just because I successfully picked a chest and got some gold. Okay, so where do we want to go next? I do want to check this area out because this is one of the areas like this one here which I haven't checked out yet. So... Or do I just want to follow the river instead? It might lead us somewhere, I don't know. And then again, there are these chamber sort of things here which I do want to check as well, so... Tell you what, I'll go ahead and clear this area out and then I'll check this part out. Should be here. What is this? Two doors? Oh, I see. I was wondering who took a swing at me. And the worst part about these guys, these iron golems, is that iron golems and fire demons in general, and even those things there, those flying things, I think they're homunculi. The worst part about them is that you can't take them out without having a proper iron sword. Sorry, not an iron sword. A proper sword with enchantments. Pardon me. Not enchantments, what I mean is a sword of rarer metal. So unless and until you have a sword of rarer metal, you can't exactly expect to take them down. A potion of... yeah, I need to heal first and then I shall use a potion of resist shock. Now to close the distance and brush them off. The game certainly has some balancing issues. I wouldn't hold it against the developers because, I mean, to be frank, this is a 1994 game, but giving the enemies reach is something that, you know, well, you have none as a warrior is something of a balancing issue. But then again, I mean, that is a huge part of Dungeons & Dragons as well, primarily the one game which this one was modeled after, so I don't think I would, you know, hold it against them for doing something like that. And I guess this is just one of those places which is like a death trap, supposed to be like a death trap, because there isn't anything else here. But at least I cleared it out, so yeah. At least I now know not to visit here. If the same logic follows, this area should be similar as well. Huh. You know, I'm really curious to see what the river holds for me. So what I'm gonna do next is I'm just gonna go ahead and swim in the river. I am going the right way, yes? Yes, I am. So before I do anything, I will take this opportunity to save here. And this is another one of the problems with this game. It's that can you die, please? Okay, there was one behind me as well. The problem with this one of the other problems with this game is that if you're levitating and you're on a raised platform like that place over there, you'll get stuck temporarily on your upward trajectory. You keep bobbing up and down while you're levitating. So yeah. This game wasn't terribly polished, but even for what it is, I like it. I certainly do like this game. Oh my god. Okay, time to face the wraith. What the fuck were you doing behind me? It is quite unbecoming of you to ambush me like that. You're a wraith, for God's sake. Just in the room, I see. Nothing more. You know what? I'm guessing this place is practically the same thing as well. In fact, I think there really is nothing here. It's just another place with a platform in the middle, just like this part. Or it might be something. But still, my guess is that this room is just like a tiny room limited to size, limited to like this large in size, because otherwise it would really be a little difficult to play. Anyway, since I won that encounter, that calls for another save. What do we have here? Literally nothing? No gold? Why do we... sometimes I wonder why I even bother with these games. Like, actually exploring this game. But oh well. As long as... yeah, it is what it is. Question is, where do I want to go next? Should I head downwards now? Sounds like a sound decision to make. I guess I will. I will head downwards. At least this room is well lit, unlike these rooms here. Wait, where was the entrance again? Hold up. Yeah, I'm looking at it. There should be another door here? Huh. Oh yeah, it's on this side. I see. At least I stopped levitating now, so that should make one of these things easier for me. And there seems to be another pedestal there, a platform. But yeah, I'm not too eager to go ahead and explore that place. I mean, for one, it probably doesn't have the way to the next floor. So, okay. Time for you to die. Any more? Yeah, I'm just gonna pop in a potion of resist fire nonetheless. And I shall save, because saving is quintessential to this game. Middle of nowhere, let me just save here, just to be safe. Okay, seems like a pit room. This looks sort of interesting, but yeah, that's probably just water. This was a small room. Okay, there's only one way to go. So we go there. Yeah. Another pit room. As expected. Nice pattern. Maybe I'll use this as a screenshot. So I am... although I just started, I am primarily a YouTuber and... I'm just streaming this game on Twitch as well. Just for the sake of it, streaming it. So... yeah, I mean, My primary concern always heads out towards YouTube when I'm making these videos. So yeah. I guess I'll just check this place out as well. While I'm at it. Lava room. Oh. I mean, I haven't found any enemies yet, so might as well loot while I have the chance. Seriously? So this is another way you can open boxes. Warhammer enchanted. Nope. No space for you, sir. Begone. And save. I need to cross over from this side, it seems. Whoa, no enemies in all this loot. Seriously. Not enchanted. Time to drop. Braces. They should be enchanted. Anyway. Okay, so I will just... should I? I'm wondering, should I keep my Ring of Healing and my Braces of Heal True as backups? Because I don't really need them. I could probably boost my stats otherwise if it wasn't for those two things taking up slots like that. So, I guess I shall just, you know, sell them off as well and replace them with something like Ebony Braces or something. Or Braces of Agility or anything of that nature. If they are things which do exist. Is there anything here? I really would like to check. There seems to be a door here. I don't know why, but it was hidden behind. Like, it was placed just beyond reach for some reason. And usually when you see signs like these, it's basically an indication that you're not going the right way. Ah, skeletons. Wait, is it? Yeah. There was one behind me as well. A vampire. I sure hope there isn't a vampire here. They're tough fuckers. Do I save here? Yes, I do. In just a moment, I'll just put this on. Don't disturb here, right here. Nothing here but vampires. Now I understand why there was a space between the door and, you know, the way towards it. So, anyway, moving on. For a Nord warrior wearing heavy armor, I sure do jump a long distance. Another bedroom. With at least these are, at least these are melee enemies, which aren't too much of a bother, because if they weren't, then yeah, things would have been much more difficult right now. And these aren't too high level at that, so a Davos shield, that is nice, but is it enchanted? It's not. Time to drop it. No point in carrying things which aren't enchanted. They won't fetch me any gold and they just eat away at my very limited inventory space. Something about the design of this place tells me that I'm headed in the wrong direction. But that's fine, I mean, I'm not exactly in a hurry to find the objective and leave either. So, let me just get this straight. There's only one door into this place. So I guess the only remaining way for us to go is all the way back through here and we head down. Unless, I mean, if we are gonna go there, might as well just check this area out while we're at it. So, but hey, this dungeon is long. It's quite long. I mean, even though I discovered all this area, I still can't map it out, so... It is what it is, I guess. To the right. To the left. And from here, where do I go from here? I mean, we can check out whatever's here, if there is at all anything here, but yeah. You know what, I'm just gonna risk it and I'm just gonna leave that area alone for now. I mean, I don't exactly want to use a potion of levitation here, so... But there does certainly seem to be something over on this end, so... You know what, let's just save here. Let us just save here, and we shall then check it out. Oh no, it was his wall. I know, there's a ghoul there. Oh wait, it's a zombie, it's not even a ghoul. That's interesting. Yeah, just hold up, wait your turn please. I know you're all eager to die, but it's a little polite to wait for your turn. So what do I have? I have the leprosy. Amazing. Yeah, I don't need to pill for anything right now. I want to use a potion of purification. I love these potions. They not only restore your health by a great margin, but they also get rid of all the diseases, so it's like a little win-win. And there is more to this place. Interesting. So if I take this road here, where do I end up? Do I get a link up with this road? The one which I left behind? Because it seems to be a wall on this end. Another big disadvantage to swimming is that you lose your stamina really quickly. So, you know what? Everything is hinting at the same thing. That I need to take this path. Not this path, this river down to the objective probably. So, I am going to try that out. I mean, I am eager to try that out, so... Let's see how it goes, I suppose. But until then, while we're here, why don't we just go ahead and check this part of the map out. Because that is something that I do want to map out, in case the objective is right there. Wait, yeah, right here. It's a glitched out zombie. How amazing. Thank you for your death. It makes my eyes tear up. I'll just save it here. And then open this room to face a ghost who just tried to thunderclap me. Okay, not too bad. Is there another ghost here? No. Sometimes you can see like a red pixel on the screen, which resembles a dead pixel, but it's just more of a rendering error. Where are you? You know what, I'm just gonna save it. And then I shall deal with your bullshit later. For all I know, you might be down there, so... Yeah. And I think I've already been through here. Some of the dungeons I really like because they're quite bright and you can practically see a lot of things. Like this place here, it's well lit. You can see a lot of things, but in some cases they're not. They're just plain old bad. And let me just go ahead and save the game here again. Well, I certainly seem to be. So, do you want to clear this area? Let's just go ahead and do that. Let us take this procedurally and see where we have to go. I think we've covered all these areas, so what we need to clear out is this part here. It's well lit! Isn't that amazing? Skeever. I keep calling them skeevers. I think it's a habit that I picked up from Skyrim. At this point, I'm just looking for... Seriously? For the entrance to the next level, because that is all I honestly care about. A mark, a longsword. Usually longswords are enchanted. Is this one enchanted though? It is, and it's probably the longsword of Firestorm, if I'm not wrong. Which is actually quite an amazing longsword. It sells for 20k. And to add on top of that, it is... How do I put this? It's... it has the Firestorm ability. You can use that to like bring on a literal Firestorm onto your foes. Potion of Healing. Potion of Resist Fire. And yeah. So yeah, you can literally bring about a Firestorm onto your enemies using this sword. And yeah, that actually does a lot of damage. Believe it or not. Nothing here. Do you want to check this area out? Doesn't have to check, right? Wait, what? A ghoul? So, 48 gold pieces, let's go. So I guess that's what waiting for me across... Not across, like over in the other door there. A wraith who did not attack me. How polite of you, sir, to wait for me to engage you in melee combat. You could have had me, but you didn't. And that is what makes a noble fool, ladies and gentlemen. I'm just rambling at this point. I don't know if any of you guys are watching or not, but yeah. I mean, we can go further down into the map, but that's really a very long way to take, and what I would be more comfortable doing is clearing out the entire breadth of the map first before proceeding downwards. I mean, this dungeon hasn't been awfully difficult, and like thus far, but yeah, but still. Because as I've observed, the recent trend in dungeons is to put the entrance near the center. And that actually makes things a little difficult for people. I suppose it is intended to do just that, but yeah. I mean, you can... Okay, who... It was... Oh my god. Yeah. So I was talking about these guys. These hellhounds. It's difficult to see them, and they've got like this special triple ranged attack. If you get caught in one of those, you're dead. I don't care who you are dead. As dead as roasted meat. I mean, I guess I had the rest of this area covered, but part of me still does want to check. Let's do that then. Let's check. Wait, wasn't there a door there? Oh. Wait, what? Yeah, there should be a door here. Have I saved? I think I did. Well, these guys aren't super strong, like these winged homunculi. They don't disappear, hellhounds do, so... Yeah. I guess that sort of balances them out as enemies because it makes them a little more difficult than hellhounds. The simple fact that they don't actually disappear. This room is yellow. I guess it's something of a marker, I suppose. I don't know. I I see it over there. Even the doors are quite well placed in this map. There aren't a lot of hidden doors, I've noticed. And in the previous few dungeons, hidden doors were like sort of the thing to go for these developers at least. You constantly had to open your map to check in case you walked past a hidden door. I hope there isn't one here. There isn't. That is good. I like that. I like that for a fact. Now the question is, do I really want to go back here? I mean, for all I know, that is where the objective might be. But then again, I mean, I probably will get chances to do that later as well. So what I am going to do for now is take this path here and go down the center. Unless I want to branch out and clear this path out first. Choices. Difficult choices. I guess I'll just head down the center first. That river... My instinct just tells me that that river looked more or less promising. But, yeah. It may just be that the river is of no significance at all as well, so best to just go with the devil that we know than the devil that we don't. I wonder where I heard that line. Ah, cool, it's amazing. I mean, these guys give you diseases, but it's fine. 56 gold pieces, amazing. Let's save again. For the sake of 56 gold pieces, you know, we just got 56 gold. Wait, what was that? Ah, this guy. I thought that was like a cold animation, like something like an ice wolf came over to attack me. Heal true. Nah, no potions of resistance for the time being. Let's save here.